name, above all names, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Let's clap our hands. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. And by this night, hallelujah, we will call our pastor, Pastor Willie Mahadoba. Amen. To greet and introduce our
praise the Lord. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated. Wow, what a wonderful Spirit of God tonight. And once again, I would like to say thank you. Thank you for coming in today. And as a family of God, it is our joy to welcome you. We have a lot of activities tomorrow. Actually, the wheels are going black. We have people from Calgary. Some other places will be coming to have fellowship with us, as Slavelink or Fort McMurray. So I'm excited. I think some of the brethren from Slavelink are here already. So amen, thank the Lord. Yeah. Oh yeah, my friend, Brother Thunder. A friend of my son. They're already, so praise the Lord. All right, so tonight, actually we'll not really speak very long because I would like to, we have Brother Philip will, we'll speak a little bit tonight before we have our main speaker. Amen. We are visited by an angel, our missionary, so, he'll be singing and he'll be doing something for us. But tonight, amen, I would like to introduce to you Brother Philip Willie Mahadukon. Is a pastor of a very thriving together, United Pentecostal Church in Davao City. And right now, by the help of God, for 6 years, we are already like more than 600 people in His church. And Philip is a graduate of Apostolic Center of Theoretical Studies in Manila. Amen. He finished his college in Manila, praise the Lord, and currently he is the district youth president of Southern Mindanao District, the mother district of Mindanao, and he is also the national youth secretary all over the Philippines. Amen. Yes. Praise the Lord. And he experienced so thankful that the Lord has allowed him to come. And he'll be preaching tomorrow. He'll be preaching tomorrow. But tonight, he will greet us and say something, encourage us a little bit. Okay, God bless.
Would you give a real worship to the Lord tonight? Dreaming of. You haven't been, if you haven't been in my shoes yet. Everything right now is a reality and a testament that when you serve a great God, He will grant the desire of your heart. I am so blessed, you guys. Praise God. I was controlling myself. I don't want to get revived inside a plane 12 hours. But I was so blessed to even think of the goodness of Jesus and all that He has done. My soul cries out, hallelujah. My soul longs for you. I am blessed. Just standing here is a miracle by itself. To even worship with you guys is a miracle by itself. I do believe that the God we are serving, He doesn't care about culture or differences or skin color. He doesn't care. Because I have known the God that I serve. He's the God in Jamaica. He's the God in Africa. He's the God in the Philippines. He's the God in the U.S. He's the God in Germany. God. And I am so glad, praise God, you guys. And, you know, I'm here not just to be a visitor. I'm here to deliver the word of God coming from a different country.
All right.
We've heard from you.
Yes.
Canadian people in the history of the Pentecost have been a great part of the Philippines.
All right.
Even up until now, every year we get people from Canada to come to the Philippines, and they're a blessing.
Yes.
Always a blessing for them to come. And actually, even though we're different in color and we are different in words, and I might not say a few languages in gratitude. You are the hand of God revealed in my life.
Amen.
Wow. You made a miracle in my life. And whatever, wherever this guy will be, the Canada Church, especially Faith Revival Church, is a molding factor in my life. I do believe that even in this place, there is still faith and revival in this place. I am not just here. I told you the other day that I'm not here just to visit my parents. I miss them. I love to fellowship them every day. You know, I'm still struggling with time difference. My body would say it's already like 10 in the morning, but you know, and I'm here standing, and it's already like 8 in the evening, and it's different for me because 8 in the evening in our place is very dark already, and you didn't hear, it's still light. Not until 11. You know, praise God. But nonetheless, we will see greater things happen. But it's not an easy job. The Bible says greater works. Does it say greater sit down? I don't know about your culture. It does say greater laziness. It doesn't say greater friction and fussing and fighting. And it's actually saying greater works than these.
Wow.
What are these? I do believe that we are here because of the faith that we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. I do believe that there is hope for tomorrow, because we are looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of that great God and Father Jesus Christ. And I believe also that what gathered us together here is not the invitation card.
Mm-hmm.
Or the pretty suits.
Mm-hmm.
Or the food. We gathered here because we understood that there is love in this place. As a preview of the preaching tomorrow, the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 13:30. There are three things, great things in the Bible.
Wow.
Faith. And now abideth faith. Thank you, whoever you are over there. And now abideth faith, hope, and charity.
Wow.
These three.
Wow.
But the greatest of this is charity.
Right.
I might not know your language. In an Askumala Mantu. But I know, it's the Spanish word of God.
Gloria
a Dios. Yeah, whatever. I'm sorry.
Hallelujah.
Purihin natin ang Panginoon, mga kapatid. But even though the deaf, those that cannot speak because they cannot hear, understand what is love.
Yes.
And the greatest of all is, we love one another.
Wow.
Would you just worship the Lord right now? Would you understand me? Would you just lift up the voice, your voices to the Lord? Wonderful feeling to hear wonderful amen words of God, amen, and yeah, we're excited for tomorrow. I was a little bit concerned about him because if they're in Davao, they are the song in English, they are translating it into our own dialect. And when I was there, I am teaching the people to speak English. Even when they give the testimonies, that's why our children, amen. And I wish you would see my daughter with joy speaking English to her. And we're just proud. She will laugh at my English. Even my grandson said, I thought you're in Canada, why are you speaking Cebuano? my grandson said, so. But anyway, I was a little bit concerned. I said, you need to practice, and because we are using, in our preaching here, we are using our own dialect, Cebuano. And if you will go to Manila, so we speak in Tagalog. But thank God that, our son, Philip, is here. And thank you for all your love, your support. We are really affected. And you just don't know how happy my wife is, Sister Maggie. She was really helping the work of God here, and you just don't know her sacrifice. It's not easy for a mother to give the children. The grandchildren is not easy, I tell you. Some other pastors, they don't understand it. There is a big why they're asking. But because of our love to you. And just even because of the will of God. Amen. Position, I have a lot of position for you. We are here because of souls. Even one or two souls that we can bring. Amen. We can encourage more young people. And when we're gone, a lot of young men and women or meet people that God will use.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. You will remember that there was a time that Brother and Sister Mahatukan even was here. Praise the Lord, encouraging us and be a blessing to my family. So I hope your parents will really count a great blessing, praise the Lord, that your children are even, they're trained to worship God. So tonight, as what I have said, we are visited by an angel.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Yes. 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 Yes.